Alright, what's poppin'? It's your boy Big Rich. Salute. Salute to my boy Shattered, the co-producer of Mob Stories, and pretty soon I'm gonna have Vic Vega put up the change in the banner, you know, hosted by Big Rich, co-produced by Shattered, because Shattered is the one that gathers all the articles from all the other places, puts it together and sends it to me for us to put it out as Mob Stories. So salute to you, my friend. Yeah, I got to give it to Shattered, man. He's relentless. I kind of respect that about him. He doesn't stop. Boom, boom, boom. Article, 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 article. Let's go, let's go, let's go. And I appreciate it. So don't ever feel like you're overdoing it. Overdoing it is good sometimes. You understand what I'm saying? Shattered. So constantly just keep hitting me with it. And we will get through all the things we want to do. And we're going to have a new segment coming up soon. I got to talk to Vic Vega today. Where we're going to create an email where you mob story listeners that enjoy all this shit that we do, that you could send in questions to Shattered. Shattered will answer them, and we'll do a live show, and I'll read your questions and answers on the air. Let me get some feedback in the comments if you guys like that, all right? Let's get down to business. Stevie Junior rejects 10 years for murder, takes 13 years for racketeering. As his dad juggles lawyers, just like we spoke about, Stevie Jr., Crea begins a long bid, one that could have been longer if he copped a plea for 13 years in prison rather than plead guilty to the murder of former Pope Purple Gang leader Michael Meldish and get a better deal of 10 years behind bars. But according to his plea agreement, the mob capo admits that his conduct as a member of the racketeering conspiracy that killed Meldish calls for a prison term of 30 years to life. The immediate result of Crea's guilty plea deal is that the 47-year-old wise guy is back behind bars as a violent criminal awaiting sentencing for being part of an aborted plot to kill a rival mob associate who dissed Stevie Jr.'s powerhouse mobster dad, Lucchese underboss Steven Stevie Wonder Crea, during a brouhaha with the Bonanno family back in 2012. In the court session on Tuesday, Crea Jr. pleaded guilty to murder conspiracy and assault charges in planned retaliation for the 2012 dust-up that took place at a Bronx social club. He also admitted being part of a racketeering enterprise from 2000 to 2017. The two charges for the 2012 plot call for a maximum of 8 years. The racketeering count a maximum of 5. The Meldish murder is not contained in any of the charges Stephen Jr. pled guilty to. And Crea Jr. did not mention the November 2013 gangland-style slaying of the longtime Lucchese associate during the lengthy proceeding before White Plains federal judge Kathy Seibel. In outlining his crimes involving the 2012 dispute, Crea Jr. told Seibel that he conspired to kill and to assault the victim in order to maintain his position in the criminal enterprise. As for the racketeering count, he stated that he agreed to commit the crimes of gambling and extortion and that in 2005, he directed others to confront a group of individuals to use threats of force for the purpose of gaining control over illegal gambling machines in the Bronx. After he pled guilty, prosecutors Hagen Scott and Celia Cohen cited statutes that mandate incarceration once a defendant has been convicted of a violent crime and asked the judge to put Crea Jr. back behind bars as he had been for the 14 months after he was indicted. The judge who released him on $1 million bond last August when she ruled that the account of the Meldish murder by the government witness who fingered Stevie Jr. for it was totally wrong. Attorneys Joseph D. Bendetto and Seth Ginsburg, who had secured Crea Jr.'s release on bail last year, asked that he be allowed to return home until sentencing day, currently set for December. They argued that the intended victim in the 2012 feud was never harmed and that their client's exemplary conduct during the past year showed he was not a danger to the community. After researching the relevant statutes, Seibel ruled that his detention was mandatory and remanded him. After turning and blowing a kiss to his family members and mouthing the words "I love you" to them, Stevie Jr. was led out of the courtroom and began serving whatever prison term he will ultimately receive on Tuesday evening. Crea Jr.'s plea agreement states very clearly that on sentencing day, a maximum prison term he faces is 13 years. In a joint statement, they added Steve did not allocate. So basically what Steven did was he turned down a plea offer of 10 years to the murder of Meldish and took 13 years instead. So in reality, how does that help his dad? Does this help his father, or does this not help his father? I think that's the question now. But still, he took 13 years. It is what it is. That's it, 13 years. Again, rejects 10 for murder, takes 13 for racketeering. All right, salute again. Thank you, Shattered. Keep them coming, brother. Salute to everybody. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and donate, man. We really can use the help to continue the platform, helping the platform grow, right? So salute to everybody. Thank you very much. We will see you soon.